Why do some people do well despite serious hardships? The science of resilience can help us find answers.
We define resilience as a good outcome in the face of adversity. The extent to which we can build capacities in all children early in their lives to be able to deal with whatever bumps in the road or major obstacles may be coming down the track, that's an investment in building strong human capital and healthy, productive adults.
Some children face more obstacles and adversity than others.
It's like having a parent with a major mental illness, growing up in a very socioeconomically disadvantaged community, going to schools that are not good, being exposed to violence in the neighborhood or in the home.
But some children do well despite these significant obstacles.
Resilience is that ability or set of capacities for positive adaptation, allowing you to keep in balance.
We're talking about the kinds of capacities and skills and the abilities that give people a sense of mastery and management of difficulty.
It's tempting to think about children as either having this resilient quality or not. But resilience is built over time, just as and in parallel with how the architecture of the brain is built over time.
It's not just in the person. It's in the interaction between the person and the environment.
So we care about resilience for the same reason that we care about promoting healthy development, because in many respects it is the same. We are interested in promoting resilience in children so that, despite the odds, more and more children can grow up to be productive citizens.